Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Hemant Vyas, Assistant Professor Surgery from Department of Surgery, Faculty of Homeopathic Science, Jayoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. Today's our lecture is about cellulitis. So let's see what is the definition of cellulitis. Cellulitis is a bacterial infection involving the inner layers of skin. It specially affects the dermis and subcutaneous fat. The bacteria most commonly involved are Streptococci and Staphylococcus. Causes of cellulitis: Group A Streptococcus and Staphylococcus. Injuries that tear the skin may cause cellulitis. Infection after surgery. Long-term skin conditions such as eczema or psoriasis, foreign objects in the skin, bone infections underneath the skin. An example is a long-standing open wound that is deep enough to expose the bone to bacteria. Now let's see what are the predisposing conditions that lead to cellulitis. Insects or spider bite, blistering, animal bite, tattoos, pruritic or itchy skin rashes, recent surgeries, athlete's foot. The image is given on right side of athlete's foot. It is a fungal infection of legs which is found most commonly in athletes. Next is dry skin, eczema, injecting drugs, pregnancy, diabetes and obesity, which can affect the circulation, can predispose a person to cellulitis. Now let's see what are the signs and symptoms of cellulitis. There is a rapid spreading areas of cutaneous swelling, redness and heat occasionally associated with inflammation of regional lymph nodes. The borders of the area of redness are generally not sharp and the skin may be swollen, while the redness often turns white when pressure is applied. This is not always the case. The area of infection is usually painful. You can see the images of cellulitis. The symptom of cellulitis may include pain and tenderness in the affected area, redness or inflammation of skin, a skin sore or rash that appears and grows quickly, a tight, glossy, swollen appearance of skin, a feeling of warmth in the affected area, a central area that has an abscess with pus formation and fever. Symptoms of more serious cellulitis infection are shaking, chills, a feeling of illness, fatigue, dizziness, lightheadedness, muscle ache, warm skin and sweating. Symptoms such as the following could signal that cellulitis is spreading: if there is drowsiness, lethargy, blistering and red streaks along the arm or along the path. Possible complications of cellulitis: sometimes cellulitis can spread through the body, entering the lymph nodes and bloodstream. In rare cases, it can enter into deep layers of tissues. Potential complications that can occur are a blood infection, a bone infection, an inflammation of your lymph vessels, tissue death or gangrene. Let's see how to prevent the cellulitis. If you have a break in your skin, clean it immediately and apply antibiotic ointment regularly. Cover your wound with a bandage and change it daily until a scab forms. Watch your wounds for redness, drainage or pain. These symptoms could indicate an infection. People with poor circulation or who have pre-existing condition that put them at risk for cellulitis should take extra precautions, including keeping skin moist to prevent shaking, promptly treating superficial skin infections such as athletes' foot, wearing protective equipment when working or playing, inspecting feet daily for signs of injury or infection. Now let's see how to differentiate cellulitis with other conditions. Other conditions that may mimic cellulitis include deep vein thrombosis, which can be diagnosed with a leg ultrasound, and stasis dermatitis, which is inflammation of the skin from poor blood flow. Thank you very much. Thank you for patient listening. Thank you.